On this episode, Emily Lisa tunes in to tell us more about availability zones. Be sure to listen to this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman. Welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. The goal of the high availability architecture for Azure SQL Database is to make sure you're up and running as much as possible. Today, I have joined with me Emily Lisa, who's a program manager on the Azure SQL team. Thanks for joining me, Emily.
Hi, Anna. Thanks for having me on the show.
Of course. And today, Emily's going to be telling us a little bit more about availability zones. So, Emily, can you start by just telling us, you know, what is an availability zone?
Yes. So in Azure, an availability zone is a completely separate area within a region. So within an availability zone enabled region, there is at minimum three different availability zones. And each of these availability zones has completely separate power, cooling, and networking, allowing for if there's any issue in one availability zone, for this to be not affected in the other availability zones within the same region.
So this is an Azure all up thing, but how does it really relate to Azure SQL?
So for Azure SQL, we have something called the zone redundant configuration. And this is available in the premium and business critical service tiers at no additional cost for the customer. For your premium and business critical databases are spread across the three different availability zones within that region. So what this guarantees is if there is a data center outage or a zonal level outage, this protects your database from not being available within those larger span of outages.
And when we talk about zones, are these zones within the same region and are they available in all regions?
Yes, so these zones are within the same region. It's not available for all regions yet, but we're working to expand to cover more regions. Currently, it is available for Azure SQL in Central US, East US 2, UK South, West Europe, France Central, Japan East, Southeast Asia, and Australia East. We're also in preview for West US 2 and North Europe. And in our public documentation about availability zones, we will update that regularly for each of the Azure services as this becomes available in more regions.
So I can always go check that, and we'll put the link to that in the description so people can go and check and see if it's available in their region.
Yes.
Awesome. And then, you know, how do I go about setting this up if I want to enable a zone redundant configuration on my database?
Yeah, so this is actually a really straightforward process. This can be done in ARM, PowerShell, or in Portal. I'm going to show it in Portal. So if you go to configure for your database, all you have to do is click yes for would you like to make this database zone redundant, and then apply. And then that's how you switch to the zone redundant configuration. This can be done for databases or elastic pools. And this can be done for either new databases and elastic pools or for already existing ones.
Cool. It seems pretty easy to set up.
Yeah, no, it's just one click and you have that additional high availability value.
Sweet. So where else can I go? Where else should I check to learn more about how this affects the SLA or other things?
Yes. So if you go to our SLA page, which we will provide a link for that in the description, you can see that for a premium or business critical database where the zone redundant configuration is not enabled, our SLA is 99.99%. So what this translates to in maximum minutes of downtime is 52.56 minutes of downtime per year. And by comparison, if you look at the for premium business critical databases where the zone redundant configuration is enabled, it's 99.995%, which just translates to a downtime that will not exceed 26.28 minutes of downtime per year. So by enabling the zone redundant configuration, the database will have a 50% reduction in downtime throughout a year. So this additional high availability benefit is offered at no additional cost and is pretty easy to set up for customers.
Awesome. Thanks, Emily. This was really interesting, really useful. Seems like the way to go if we want the highest availability solution in the industry. And so thanks for coming on our show today. And if you liked this video, please like the video, subscribe to our channel, and leave us a comment. Thanks, and see you next time on Data Exposed.